Meditation means to experience and be that purest state of yourself, which is beyond the rubble of your senses and the mind, which is, it is, before Abraham was, I am. Before anything was, the self is. It always was there. Not created, cannot be destroyed. Nothing to believe, nothing to disbelieve. Only experience. Take it or leave it. And that is you. The purest state of your being. You are not only a physical body. You are not only a rapist. You are not only a terrorist. You are not only a British. You are not only a Hindu. You are that. Tat Tvam Asi. The ancient sages of the Upanishad used to tell the disciples, that thou art, the kingdom of heaven is within. Same language, only one language, a different way of saying. I mean, only one truth, the different way of saying it. The Hindus would call it soul, Jesus called it kingdom of heaven within. Buddha called it nirvana, Lao Tzu called it Tao. And experiencing that, in that very body of yours, whoever you are, wherever you are, is what meditation is all about. However, very simple it may seem, it is extremely difficult to experience it. It shouldn't be like that. It is not like that. But we've gone so far away from it. We've gone extremely far away from it. That's why each time when a master comes and tell you about, let us go back home, let us go to the center of your being, people come and they expect superficial relaxation so that they can carry on with their daily chores, doing everything. Many people meditate around the world. Believe me, we have transcendental meditation, we have, you know, Goen Kakom, Vipassana, and so on and so on. Many people, but these are not really meditation. It's good. It's very good for health. It's good to carry on with your daily activities. It gives you, you know, relaxation, you can sleep well. This is all these, I'm not against it, like Reiki, very, very good. Yoga, very good. Do all these, please. However, what I am sharing with you, what I am proposing, is something infinitely greater and beyond. It is the very purpose for which we all were born. People ask me, what is the purpose of human existence? Human existence has no purpose if you live only as Zorba. I'm sure you've heard about Zorba. Zorba was a Greek and his philosophy was eating, drinking and othering. I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. And then that's it, celebrating life. Life is meant to be celebrated. The senses are meant to be celebrated. Nature is meant to be celebrated. Love, sex, all these are meant to be celebrated. But then what happens if you live only as Zorba, only as a physical being, as a physical body, then your life is incomplete and you are frustrated.